हाय एवरीवन, वेलकम टू स्टडी एसएमएल। आज का जो मेन कॉन्टेस्ट है वो है ई सिगरेट्स। सो व्हाई टू स्टडी द ई सिगरेट? सो फॉर द प्रीलिम्स एंड मेंस, ई सिगरेट्स कंसर्न्स इफेक्ट्स ऑफ ऑन द हेल्थ, नीड फॉर द रेगुलेशन, चैलेंजेस एसोसिएटेड एंड मेजर्स नीडेड। सो कॉन्टेक्स्ट इज The prohibition of e-cigarette ordinance 2019 is being sent to a group of ministers as directed by the Prime Minister Office. So what is it? The ordinance makes any violations of its provisions punishable by the imprisonment of the 1 to 3 years and fine 1 to 5 lakhs. Okay. So the draft ordinance was necessitated by the fact that an earlier order by the center asking the states to crack down against the e-cigarettes could not stand the judicial scrutiny. So however, a recent order in which the High Court threw out a petition asking for the protection from an ordinance against the e-cigarettes has emboldened the health ministry. Background kya hai? The Indian Council for Medical Research, that is ICMR, has recommended the complete ban on the electronics and nicotine, that is delivery systems, that is ENDS, including e-cigarette. The recommendation is based on the currently available scientific evidence. Why the ICMR has recommended a complete ban? Addictive in nature, e-cigarette and other such devices contain not only the nicotine solutions that was highly addictive but also harmful ingredients like the flavoring agents and the vaporizers. Availability of the flavors, variants and the attractive designs are added to the allure of the device, and globally there was an increased trend of the e-cigarette consumption among youth and adolescents. Use of the ends ENDS or e-cigarette can open a gateway for the new tobacco addictions among the masses is on the balance. Okay. These have a negative impact on the public health. Prolonged use of the ENDS or the e-cigarettes has a documented adverse impact on humans, which includes the DNA damage, respiratory, cardiovascular, neurological disorders. Carcinogenic cellular molecular immunological toxicity and even have adverse effect on the fetal development and pregnancy. Research has found that youths using the e-cigarettes are more likely to use the regular cigarettes in later period. The exposure of ENDS increased the likelihood to the experiment with regular products and increased the intention to indulge in the cigarette smoking. What are the e-cigarette? E-cigarette is just like electronic cigarette. E-cigarette is a battery powered vaporizer that mimics tobacco smoking. It works by the heating of a nicotine liquid, okay, called the juice. Nicotine juice or e-juice comes in the various flavors and the nicotine levers. E-liquid is composed of the 5 ingredients, that is vegetable glycerin, okay, and propylene, that is glycol. Then propylene glycol is the ingredient that produce thicker clouds of the vapor. Proponents kya hai e-cigarettes argues that practice is healthier than traditional cigarettes because users are only the inhaling the water vapor and nicotines. Why it's hard to regulate them? So basically e-cigarette contains nicotine and not tobacco. They do not fall within the ambit of the cigarette and other tobacco products. Okay, Act 2003, that is COTPA, which mandates the stringent health warning on the packaging and advertisement of tobacco production. Need for the regulations of the current unregulated sale of the e-cigarette is dangerous for the country like India, where the number of the smokers in the decline. WHO Global Report 2015 as it increased the possibility of e-cigarette becoming a gateway for the smoking by the inducing the nicotine addiction and perpetuating smoking by the making it more attractive, thereby encouraging the persons to become users of the tobacco as well as e-cigarette. So WHO report on the e-cigarettes and effects. As per the report, electronics nicotine delivery system, also known as the e-cigarettes, emit the nicotines. The addictive components of the tobacco products in addiction to the dependence. Nicotine can have adverse effects on the development of the fetus during the pregnancy and may contribute to the cardiovascular disease. WHO report further says that although nicotine itself is not a carcinogen, it may function as the tumor promoter and seems to be involved in the biology of the malignant disease as well as the neurodegeneration. Fetal and adolescent nicotine exposure may have long-term consequences for the brain development, potentially leading to the learning and anxiety disorders. The evidence is sufficient to warn children and adolescents, pregnant women and the women of the reproductive age against the ENDS and the use and the nicotine. Okay, thank you for discussion.